Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Great sacrifice and bring some things there. I have some questions. Why didn't the House of Tallahassee introduce a verified thing for our city? And two,
well, let's talk about what happened in the state, and in fairness, I think that question is probably best addressed to our Senate President, because we have a supermajority in both houses in the state legislature, and nothing got done. Let me tell you that there are big special interest groups that fought it, some for different reasons, okay? Some because they are afraid of the impact on the state's tourism hospitality industry. There is some truth, okay, to the fact that if you implement this type of program and other states around you don't, that you're going to be in competition with them for convention business and so forth. I'm not saying that's right. I'm not saying that's not a reason to do it, okay? It's one of the reasons that I think the federal government should do this, okay? But I think it's a very fair question to some of the opponents I have in this race that are in Tallahassee. The agriculture, to your point, the agricultural lobby, okay? Some good friends of our whole agriculture economy in the state, okay, was up in arms over it, okay? And so that big special interest group, who gives a lot of money to political candidates, okay, I think had a huge impact on it not coming to a vote. And who was responsible for that in Tallahassee, or who behind the scenes torpedoed it, I can't answer that because I'm not in Tallahassee. But I think if we can get a federal mandated verification, we'll mute the decision. Okay.
Okay, my second question is,
yes.
You came within a whisker
Well, you know, sometimes in running for political office, you not only have to look at where you think you can make the most impact, but like any business that I've ever been involved with, you got to be able to see a path to meeting your objective. Okay, I want to serve.
What do you recommend? Okay.
And right now, there's a lot of uncertainty of how the districting is going to be redistricted, okay? And I said, when Sandy Adams won the Republican primary, okay, I endorsed her 5 minutes after, and I realized in my own mind that I was not going to win, okay? And I told Sandy 2 weeks later, you're going to win this race, and I will not run against her, okay? She's a good, sound, conservative Republican. She's going to do a good job, okay? If there was a clear path to being elected to Congress, okay, that would have been an option that I might have looked at. I look at this race and I see four career politicians, okay, or three career politicians in this race. Colonel McAllister is not, but the other three are. I see an opportunity to serve, and to be honest with you, I feel more comfortable running for the U.S. Senate because the issues that come before the U.S. Senate are so compelling, like court appointees. They're long-lasting decisions. I'm not a short-term looking person. I like to look out and plan and make decisions based on where the direction the boat's going in. Okay. This is a huge ship, as we would call it in business. Okay, you don't make, you know, you got to make these kind of adjustments. And once the ship's on a path, it's very hard to turn it around. I want to get to Washington, and I want to bring a retirement to Mr. Nelson. I want to make Marco Rubio our senior senator from Florida. I want two votes from this great state supporting fiscal conservatism. And I think I'm the best person to beat Bill Nelson. Because if we don't beat Bill Nelson, okay, we have a chance of not recapturing the Senate, and we're going to have, you know, another long period of time. Well, I think veterans helps. 25% of the Republicans that vote in primaries in Florida are veterans. Okay. I was meeting yesterday with Medal of Honor winner Kittinger in Florida, in Orlando. I've got an enormous amount of support building in the veterans community. I have a great lot of support coming from the business community, as you would expect. 56% of the people that vote in Republican primary are in the I-4 corridor. I'm smack dab in the middle of it in Orlando. I've operated restaurants in Sarasota that have been with Louis Chris down here for the Red Lobster. I went to Florida Public Schools my whole school career. I graduated from Central Florida and went to Florida State for a couple of years. I went to Cocoa High School and I volunteered for the Air Force when I was 18 years old. I volunteered to go to Vietnam when I was 19. And I've been a restaurant executive and a career job builder all my life. And I'm ready to serve folks like you, and I'm anxious to get on with it.
Two things. One, I would like you to kind of just give us your thoughts on the balanced budget amendment. This being talked about, everybody thinks that the federal government should have a balanced budget amendment. I personally find it to be a show and a shell game. All it does is allow the federal government to spend 18 or 20% of the GDP, whether they need to or not,
Yeah. And
can vote to raise the taxes if they have to, and can vote to change it if they have to. And to me, it's a bunch of people that want to get their names written down in history, is what it looks like, more than anything that's really going to do any good. When what we've got to do is get the federal government out of all this nonsense they ran in the first place. So that's one thing. Second thing, why is there a conflict between what Bill Nelson does and what Marco Rubio does? Why are senators not working for the state?
You're talking about 17th Amendment?
No, boy, am I.
let's take that one. You know, I think that you know, there's a lot of validity to repeal the 17th Amendment. I will also say that, given the state of affairs today, it will not be the number one thing I work on when I get to Washington. I'm concerned about you losing your future. I'm concerned about my grandson and my children. I'm concerned about people that are losing their house. I want to get our economy on sound footing. The way we solve our economic deficit problem, okay, is to reduce spending and increase revenue. Now, the revenue comes from economic growth. It doesn't come from higher taxes. When we got everybody working, we don't have a problem. When we've got full productivity, we don't have a problem. So my focus, and it's laser, I met with Governor Scott. I got some great advice from Rick Scott. And that was, you have an opportunity to be the next senator from Florida. Deal with the issues that are most important to Floridians today. And focus on those, and you will have a huge impact on people's lives today. We're going to think long term. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the fair tax. All of these things are going to be going on. But right now, we need to get our government to stop kicking the can, as they like to say, and let's deal with getting this economy straightened out. Let's get this spending down, and let's get shackles off of small business owners so that they feel comfortable going out and putting capital to work. And until we do that, we're going to sit here and fight over raising the debt limit for the next 30 years, okay, if we don't fix this. And that's what I'm going to do. I've got to run. I've got another group down the street at Starbucks. I guess I'm going to have some Starbucks coffee next.
And you're going to be so coffeeed up by the time we see the REC. It's not even funny.
Close. Actually, I'm not sure it's that one or there's another one down here.
There's one on 41 down about 2 or 3 miles. Well, this is the Tamiami Trail.
Okay.
Tamiami Trail covers from Tampa to Miami. That's a lot. Who all have we got here today? Who's here today? Let me get you guys on camera. Who we got? Turn around here. Turn around here, Mo. Come on, Mo. What's your name, and what'd you come here for?
Protection program. Lily.
What did I come here for?
Yeah, who are you? This is going up on YouTube. Who are you?
Okay.
What are you here for?
I just wanted to know what was going on as far as what he was going to do different to the people that are in right now. And God knows we need something.
Very good. Who's next over there?
Go Graham?
Yeah.
I came to hear Craig. Very interesting.
Thank you, Graham. Good to be here.
Who's next? Who we got there?
Lily.
Yeah.
I'm here because I really wanted to find out how he felt about the unemployment. And what he's going to do about here in Florida is 18.6% of those out of work. That's pretty high.
Yes, it is. Who's that sitting back there in the picture? Who is that right there?
I'm Nicole. I work for Craig.
You work for Craig?
Yes.
Doing what?
I'm his finance director.
Oh, hot dog. You got an interesting job.
This is Paul and Nicole, and they are my team right now. So that's, you've got the whole group.
That's
here.
Paul right there? Okay, fine, great. Who's the fellow in the scrubs back here? Who we got? Who's it?
Dave Foss. I just wanted to come and meet Craig and see who's lining up for the race here to beat Bill Nelson.
There you go. Gotta love that. Gotta love that. Who we got down here?
I'm Eileen Green, and I just wanted to see how he would stack up. I've heard Lemieux speak already, and just wanted to see what was going on here.
All right, very good. Let me get a little different shot at this because I've got a light strike problem from the window. Go ahead. Who we got?
I'm Linda Larson, and I just wanted to meet Craig and find out what's important to him, if it's the same as important to me.
Excellent. Very good. Mr. Miller, if you would kind of just give us a quick thanks to the 13 Patriots, that would be great.
You bet. Well, thanks very much for having me here today. It's great to meet with you folks. Let's do this again. How about that? You know, I would enjoy that, and I'll buy the coffee next time. And I am Craig Miller. I'm running for the United States Senate, and I am proud to be an American and really proud to be a Floridian as well.
Thank you very much for coming out today. Thank you so much.
I'll see you in a little bit. I'm going to the
RBC. Oh, you do? Okay.
Yeah, most of us will probably see you again tonight.
Yeah, okay. Great. Thank you very much. Well, you can give me a standing ovation when I come in the room.
Okay, I'll see what I can do.